Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. In today's video, we are going to create an overlap vector design using Illustrator. We'll look at how to use Make with Map option to make your workflow much faster. So let's begin with the designing process. Firstly, go to File menu and open a new document. Then name it Overlap, then click OK. Now using the artboard tool, scale up the artboard size to give a landscape look. Now take a line segment tool and create out a line. By pressing the Alt key, take a copy of the line, then press Command or Control D for multiple number of duplicates. After that, select all the lines and press Command or Control 2. This will lock the lines. We're going to use these lines for reference. Now, using the Pen tool, start drawing out a shape. Follow along the reference lines to create a straight and parallel line. This way, we have created a blocked shape. Next, press Command or Control Alt 2 to unlock the lines. Then select the lines and delete them. After that, select the shapes and take your die selection tool. We can see a small circular icon at the corners. Drag them to make the corners smooth. Next, by pressing Alt key, take a copy of the shape and place it parallel to it. Now take a line segment tool and fill up the shape by creating a line between them. So now we are going to create our design using the rectangular shape. For that, take the rectangle tool and create a rectangle over the lines. Fill it up with blue color and remove the stroke color. Then take a copy by pressing Alt key and place it over the middle region. Take one more copy and place it on the right side division. Now we'll adjust the shape according to the background outline. So select the first rectangle and adjust the top edge. Then go to the object, envelope distort, and then click on Make with Mesh. Under this panel, switch on preview option and choose two rows and one column. After that, take your die selection tool and select the middle anchor points of the rectangle. Drag and place them at the starting point of the corner curves. Then select the bottom two anchor points and place them at the intersection point of the corners. In the next step, start adjusting the handles in order to follow the curves of the outline. Now we'll go for the middle portion. Select the second rectangle and edit the shapes from top and bottom. Then go to Object, Envelope Distort, and click on Make with Mesh. This time choose three rows and one column. Now using a die selection tool, select the two anchor points and place them at the beginning of the top curves. Then select the other two anchor points and drag and place them at the bottom corner starting point. After that, select the top two anchor points and place them at the intersection of second and third corner. Then hold the handles and adjust them to match with the flow of the shape. Next, select the bottom anchor points and adjust the flow with the help of handles. Do the adjustments for the top as well as for the bottom. And now for the third portion of the shape, we'll take a copy of the first shape by pressing the Alt key and delete out the previous rectangular shape. Now select the copied shape and go to Reflect tool. Double click on it and it'll open the Reflect attribute panel. Here, we'll first flip horizontally, then again open the Reflect panel and flip it vertically. This will give us a perfect angle according to the flow of the design. Now place the shape over the third division. Next, select the three shapes and keep them aside. Then select the outline shapes and lock them by pressing Command or Control 2. Now take a line segment tool and create out a line. Change the stroke color to red under color swatches and increase the stroke thickness to around 6 points. We are going to create a pattern symbol to apply to our rectangular shape. So select the line and make a copy by pressing the Alt key. Here, while taking a copy, edge the gap between the lines to create a nice pattern. Then, press Command or Control D for multiple number of copies. Next, take a rectangle tool and create outer rectangle over the lines. Switch the stroke color to fill color and change the fill color to black. Now edge the size of the shape to match it with the width of the lines. After that, arrange it to back. Then select all the shapes and group them up. Now we'll convert the design into symbol. So open the symbol panel and drag and drop the group into the panel. This will open the symbol option panel. Here, change the name to pattern and click OK. Now you can delete out the group. Next, drag out the pattern symbol which we have just created and place it on the artboard. Then create another duplicate of it and place it over the shape. But before placing the pattern on the shape, select all the shapes and arrange them to front. Now place the pattern under the shape and select both the pattern and the third shape and go to Object, Envelope Distort and click on Make with Top Object. This will apply the pattern to our design with a nice curve bending at the intersection. Now repeat the same process for the other two shapes. Place the symbol below each shapes, then apply Make with Top Object. This will give you a design with an overlapping pattern. Now we'll create a background for our design. For that, let's clear our artboard area. Select all the unwanted shapes and keep it aside. Then take a rectangle tool and create outer rectangle covering the complete artboard. Fill it up with black color and send it to back. After that, select our design and scale it by holding the Alt Shift key. Now we are going to create our design like this. So here, check the gap distance between each pattern and adjust it. Now take a copy of the overlapping pattern by pressing the Alt key, then select the third pattern shape and keep it aside. Now select the middle pattern and make a copy. After that, flip the angle using the reflect tool and choose vertical angle. Now edit the pattern shape adjacent to the second shape. Select the middle pattern and bring it to front. Then select the complete design and rotate it to give a diagonal angle. Next, rotate the other overlap design tool. After that, select the artboard tool and take a copy by pressing Alt key. Delete out the unwanted parts and give the same background color for the artboard. Then select the first design and place it on the second artboard. Rotate it a bit and adjust it. Now we need to increase the length of the design shape. For that, take a die selection tool and select the top two anchor points. Drag and place it at the end of the artboard. Now select the other two pattern shapes. Then using a die selection tool, select the middle pattern anchor points and drag them to increase the length. Next, take another copy of the background and keep it in front of the pattern. After that, select the patterns and group them. Now select the pattern and the background, then right click and apply Make Clipping Mask. This will mask out the extended shapes. In the next step, we'll edit the other patterns. Take a die selection tool and select the anchor points of the pattern. Then increase the length according to our design. Repeat the same process at the top part of the pattern as well. After that, group the patterns, then make a copy of the background and place it in front of the pattern. Then select the pattern and the background, then right click and apply Make Clipping Mask. Then edit the pattern design of the artboard. Here, if you want to edit the pattern again after making the clipping mask, simply right click and release clipping mask. So now we have edited the pattern. Next, after editing the pattern, place the background on the pattern again. Then right click and apply Make Clipping Mask. Now we are going to change the pattern color. So for that, go to symbol panel and double click on the symbol which we have just created before. Here, we need to change the stroke lines color. So by pressing the Ctrl or Command 2, lock the background shape. Then select the stroke lines and apply light green color from the color swatches. Then double click outside. So our design gets updated automatically. Now we want to add the text for the title. To do that, press the shortcut T for the text tool and type out the text. Scale it up and choose a suitable font for the text. We'll apply Futura font for the text. After that, take a copy of the text by pressing the Alt key and type out different text. Scale down the size and place it under the heading. Similarly, add some more text. Next, apply some different color for the text to give a nice look. Once you complete the adjustments, select all the text and rotate the angle to make it parallel to our design. Next, take another copy of the text and place it on the other design too. Adjust the rotation angle according to your design. We can keep on adjusting your design composition until you get a nice design. Finally, we have completed creating an overlap vector design. During the process, we have seen some new techniques while creating out the concept. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.